today's top breaking news with Gitanjali from Bayan Times. Flight services in Andhra Pradesh to reopen on May 26. Flight services will not resume in Andhra Pradesh on Monday. The services will resume only from Tuesday on a limited scale. This was announced by Union Civil Aviation Minister Hardeep Singh Puri on Sunday night. As per request of state government, operations in Andhra Pradesh will recommence on limited scale from May 26, he tweeted. It appears that only 20% of the summer schedule will be operational from Vijayawada and Visakh airports. The reason for the state government's request to center to defer resumption of flight services by a day and to resume from Tuesday only on a limited scale remains a mystery. Even airport directors appeared clueless and some on condition of anonymity told TNIE that the reason could be lack of clarity on the quarantine procedures. Utter confusion prevailed through the evening till the Union Civil Aviation Minister gave clarity on Twitter around 9:30 p.m. Sources said the state government may be concerned over the increasing number of COVID-19 cases among those who are returning to the state from other states and abroad. Flight services deferred only to stop our Chief Chandrababu Naidu, says TDP. DGP Gautam Sawang has issued an e-pass to Leader of the Opposition and TDP President Nara Chandrababu Naidu to visit Visakh on Monday. However, the TDP Chief's plan to visit the port city to meet gas tragedy victims stands cancelled as domestic air travel in the state will resume only on Tuesday. In a late-night statement, TDP Leader Achyut Naidu alleged that the YSR Congress government has deliberately deferred resumption of flight services to Tuesday only to prevent the former chief minister from visiting Visakh. It is only after Chandrababu Naidu's schedule was announced that the state government deferred the resumption of services, that too only by a day. Civil Aviation Minister Hardeep Singh Puri's tweet indicate the same, he claimed. Earlier, in reply to a letter from Chandrababu Naidu, the DGP cited guidelines issued by the Union Health Ministry with regard to protection of persons aged below 65 and children below 10. Night curfew between 7 p.m. and 7 a.m. and testing for persons coming from other states as per protocol on their arrival. He also referred to directives on COVID-19 management. CGLG Polymers Plant at sea tells Andhra Pradesh government. The Andhra Pradesh High Court has directed the state government to seize the LG Polymers plant in Visakhapatnam and rule that none will be allowed inside without obtaining prior permission from the court. A division bench comprising Chief Justice G.K. Maheshwari and Justice Kaneganti Lalitha issued interim orders recently and the same were uploaded on the court's website Sunday. It may be recalled that the court has taken CO2 cognizance of the Visakh gas leak and also heard two petitions filed on the incident. As per its interim orders, members of various committees formed to probe the gas leak will have to enter their names on a register at the main gate of the plant before going in for any investigation. LG Polymers management has been directed not to shift movable or immovable assets or properties from the plant. The police, who have already seized passports of the company's directors, were ordered not to return them without permission from the court. The directors cannot leave the country without the court's nod. Andhra Pradesh minister lashes out at state opposition on TTD land auctions BJP stir tomorrow. A day after the TDP and BJP raised a hue and cry over the Tirumala Tirupati Devasthanam's TTD decision to auction 23 unviable assets in Tamil Nadu, Endowments Minister Vellampally Srinivasa Rao hit back at the opposition party, saying neither Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan-Mohan Reddy nor himself will benefit a single rupee from the proceeds of the sale. Srinivas, speaking to in Vijayawada, said it was that the previous TTD Trust Board, which constituted the committee to recommend sale of TTD properties. The committee was constituted to the previous TTD board, which was headed TDP leader Chandralauda Krishnamurthy. BJP leader Bhanu Prakash Reddy was a member in the board, he said, adding that the previous board had decided to auction 50 unviable and unmaintainable immovable properties. Unlike the previous TDP government, which issued government orders secretly to sell government lands, Chief Minister Y.S. Jagan-Mohan Reddy has no intention to sell away lands in a discreet manner, Srinivasa Rao said. Every rupee generated from the auction of the lands will go to the TTD, he reiterated. Five-month-old test positive for COVID-19 in Andhra Pradesh. A five-month-old infant who was being treated at the Pediatric Intensive Care Unit, PICU, in Kakinada Government General Hospital tested positive for COVID-19 on Sunday. District Medical and Health Officer Dr. Satya Sushila confirmed that the infant tested positive for coronavirus. According to doctors at the Kakinada Government General Hospital (GGH), a tribal couple from Rampachodavaram agency brought their baby boy suffering from cough to the Rajamurthy GGH. The doctors were referred the infant to Kakinada GGH. On Wednesday last, the couple brought the infant to the Kakinada GGH and the doctors admitted the boy to the PICU for treatment. Doctors said another infant was also given treatment at the PICU for lung infection and the baby died on Wednesday. No samples were taken from the deceased infant for test at that time. However, doctors at the PICU grew suspicious with the death of the infant with symptoms of coronavirus and reportedly asked the hospital administration to conduct tests on the 5-month-old boy on the same day. NAD flyover works gain pace in Visakhapatnam. The Rs. 113 crore NAD flyover works have gained pace with easing of lockdown 4.0 restrictions. Works came to a standstill for 60 days since the third week of March due to the nationwide lockdown. Otherwise, majority of the flyover works would have been completed and traffic thrown up open by now on the route from the airport to the city as the arm of the flyover has been ready. VMRDA Commissioner P. Koteshwara Rao said works of the flyover were taken up after the relaxation of lockdown 4.0 restrictions. Works on six pillars in the central area of the flyover are going on now. As there is not much traffic of heavy vehicles, they can speed up the works, which are going on almost 24/7. He said and added that with the deployment of advanced machinery, not much manpower is required for the project execution and this has helped them maintain social distancing. He said the four arms of the flyover, airport to city, city to airport, Gopalpatnam to 104 area, 104 area to Gopalpatnam, will culminate at the circle where the works on the pillar are going on. Another 45 foreign returnees tested positive for COVID-19 in the state, taking the total number of people returned to their native places in Andhra Pradesh from abroad to 62. Of the 45 foreign returnees who tested positive, 41 have returned from Kuwait, 3 from Qatar and 1 from Saudi Arabia. Foreign returnees apart, 44 more persons from the state tested positive for the virus, taking the state tally to 2,824. According to the media bulletin, 10,240 samples were tested in 24 hours between Sunday 9 a.m. to Monday 9 a.m. Of them, 44 tested positive. Meanwhile, 41 more persons got discharged after their recovery. With a total of 1,884 persons discharged, active cases now stands at 884. 7 more persons with travel history to Coimbatore market in neighboring Tamil Nadu tested positive for COVID-19. Srikakulam natives reach Vizag from Bengaluru on two-wheelers. Even as the country is trying to recover from the impact of lockdowns, migrant workers continue to suffer. As governments are focused on sending them to their respective states, many are given permission to ride back home on auto rickshaws or other vehicles if they own one. One such group of 30 men and women was allowed to set off from Rajam in Srikakulam from Bengaluru on two-wheelers on Wednesday. The migrants, all of whom are relatives, reached Vizag on Sunday evening. They have been making a living by selling blankets, working in construction sector and doing other odd jobs in the Karnataka capital for the last 15 years. Nagabhushan, one of the migrants, said, "We tried to survive with whatever we had, but with so many stomachs to feed, we ran out of our savings and so we thought we will be better off in our hometown." The entire family took permission from the local authorities and got themselves tested for COVID-19. As we had decided to leave, we went to the municipal corporation for permission. After testing all of us for COVID-19, they allowed us to go, said Narasingha Rao. Telangana to allow arrival departure of domestic flights. Telangana government will allow arrival and departure of all domestic flights from Monday. According to Health Minister Yattala Rajendra, passengers arriving by flights at Rajiv Gandhi International Airport (RGIA) in Hyderabad would be screened for COVID-19 symptoms and if they have any, they would be sent to quarantine centers. If they do not, they would be allowed to go straight home, he said. According to the minister, those who do not show any symptoms of COVID-19 would, however, have to take all precautions at home, and if they develop any symptoms at a later stage, they would have to call helpline numbers 104 or 108. Referring to those who are being evacuated from abroad, Yadala said that 7 days of institutional quarantining and another 7 days of home quarantining would be sufficient for them. KTR extends aid to differently able. IT and Municipal Administration Minister K.T. Rama Rao once again displayed his compassionate side on Sunday when he extended financial support to a physically challenged person. Gautam Parshuramulu, an auto rickshaw driver, was unable to move since 2018 as his legs were affected due to diabetes. While one leg was amputated below the knee, the another leg was also damaged. The family, which resides in Sirsikkala town, faced helplessness as Parshuramulu was unable to work during the last 7 years due to the health issues and had spent huge amounts of money on his treatment after selling the house. Rama Rao instructed District Collector D. Krishna Bhaskar to provide financial assistance to Parshuramulu. The collector provided ₹25,000 to the victim. Town Revenue Inspector Madhu on Sunday handed over the cheque to Parshuramulu and promised to provide pension under the PHC category. The minister thanked the collector for providing financial assistance to the family. Parshuramulu thanked Rama Rao and collector for providing financial assistance. Civil service aspirants in a sweat over UPSC prelims delay. Uncertainty haunts several hundred civil service aspirants in Hyderabad, with the Union Public Service Commission (UPSC) having indefinitely postponed the preliminary exam for this year amid the COVID-19 outbreak. The Telangana State Public Service Commission (TSPSC) has not announced any updates so far. Aspirants are worried that they have dedicated months and years of their lives to cracking the exam. I took a break from my job last year and invested all my savings into getting enrolled in a coaching center. Now, I'm not so sure if the exam would even be conducted this year, said a 32-year-old IAS aspirant, Yunus Ahmed. He added, "This would be my last chance to appear for the exam as I would not be eligible for it next year." Yunus, who hails from Khammam, resides at a PG facility in Ashok Nagar. Though the coaching center has been shut down, he has not been able to return home due to the lockdown. Hyderabad Police Commissioner Anjani Kumar suspends Home Guard for harassing woman doctor. The Hyderabad Police Commissioner Anjani Kumar on Sunday issued orders for suspending a Home Guard working in traffic wing for harassing a woman doctor by making calls to her. According to the order, S. Venkat Swarlu has been placed under suspension with immediate effect for his misconduct. The police commissioner said that the city police remain committed to exemplary conduct of its officers and protection of dignity of all its citizens. Sources said that the Home Guard detained a woman doctor a few days ago while she was going to the hospital. At the time, the Home Guard also collected the doctor's mobile number and later started calling her. Unable to bear the harassment, she lodged a complaint with police through Hawkeye. As there was no response, she approached the Hyderabad Commissioner of Police along with her friends. Responding to the incident, the CP issued orders suspending the Home Guard. Three tests positive for COVID-19 in Jaishankar, Bhopalpalli district. Three youths of Korishala village of Mogulapalli Mandal in the district have tested positive for the COVID-19 on Monday, according to District Medical and Health Officer DMHO Dr. Gopal Rao. In a press note released here on Monday, he said that a 22-year-old from Ramchandrapur village of Chityal Mandal also tested positive for COVID-19 on Sunday. It is said that these patients were the primary contacts of a 75-year-old man of Nawabpet village of Chityal Mandal who tested positive on May 22 and his wife tested positive on the next day. All the patients were shifted to Gandhi Hospital, Hyderabad for treatment. It is said that the patients had returned native migrants from Mumbai recently. With the record of the new cases, the total number of positive cases reached 7. Meanwhile, officials have visited Korishala village and are on the job to trace the primary and secondary contacts of the positive cases. ₹1.58 lakh migrants transported so far, Chief Secretary. Following the directions of Chief Minister K. Chandrasekhar Rao, officials arranged 40 trains from various railway stations to transport over 50,000 migrant workers to their respective places on Saturday. The transportation cost of 13.15 crore was borne by the state government. Chief Secretary Somesh Kumar appreciated police and railway officials for ensuring that there was no inconvenience to migrant workers. Somesh Kumar said that till date, over 1.58 lakh migrant workers had been shifted to their native places through 124 trains. The migrants were also sent to railway stations through TSRTC buses from different locations and supplied 2 food packets, 3 water bottles and fruits each. The process of sending the migrant workers who wanted to return to their native places has reached its final stage. The migrants who hail from Amphan-hit West Bengal will be sent back as and when the situation improves there. 10 special trains were made ready for West Bengal migrants, said Somesh Kumar. With this, we conclude with our today's news headlines. For more such latest news and updates, like, share and subscribe by N Times.